Now, the latest blockbuster from the house of Mercedes-Benz India has to be this, the AMG E53 Cabriolet. What a stunning looking car, right? Well, at the same time, this car sometimes leaves me in a confused state. Why do I say so? Well, on one hand, this is the epitome of performance in a topless manner in the Indian car market, the topless as in the hood is down. And on the same time, on the other hand, it's a very comfortable car to live on a daily basis. It's got space for four people on the inside, and in spite of the tiny sidewalls, it's got a comfortable ride. And in urban conditions, if you aren't pushing the engine too much, it behaves in a very relaxed manner. So does this car have multiple personalities? I think so, but in a good way. And how much do you pay for a car like this, a versatile car like this? Well, the asking price is 1.3 crores before the road tax, insurance and other elements come into the picture. On-road pricing, well, over 1.5 CR. Worth paying for a car like this? Let's find out.
The E53 looks drop-dead gorgeous, especially with the top down. It is not loud but graceful and looks oh so awesome from all angles. The front is a lot like the E-sedan but of course with ample AMG elements thrown in, right from the low bumper to the pan Americana grille. Love this particular design. And then you have these LED performance headlamps. The side profile showcases how long the E53 really is. At almost 5 meters, it is even longer than big SUVs like the Fortuner and the Endeavour. The E53 sits on large 20-inch alloy wheels and these do come with a narrow sidewall. Does this hamper the ride quality? Well, you will come to know in a while. The doors are also large, which is needed while climbing into the rear seats. At the back, you do notice the quad exhaust setup, but not all the outlets are working ones. That said, the E53 sounds good on the move. There is prominent AMG badging and also a tiny boot spoiler. Also, I must admit, while white isn't a color we associate with sports cars, on the E53, this shade looks great.
Now with the roof down like this, my seat is currently on the lowest position, and for a 6 feet tall driver, I have approximately a couple of inches of headroom left over here, so pretty good in that aspect. I'll do one thing, I'll take the top off and then speak to you with in an airy cabin with more light on the inside. You can do this at speeds of up to 50 km/h, definitely a party trick. And there you go, the roof is completely down, the perfect done. So with the top down, you do get a very very airy feel on the inside. By the way, safety is taken care of in a very good manner. In an unfortunate case of the car about to topple over or in a very emergency kind of a maneuver, there is a safety aspect at the back of the rear headrest which open up, and in case the car does topple, it will give you a proper cocoon in terms of any head injury coming in. So that is what Mercedes-Benz is all about. The interior design is more like its sibling, the E-sedan, but of course with a lot of AMG elements, and these elements are spread across the cabin, from the door sills with the AMG branding to the floor mats to the special seat upholstery. Both the seats are powered. They're not ventilated, but both the seats are powered, to the AMG steering wheel with the special AMG dynamic rotary knob over here. You also have AMG elements on the screen. If you want to basically know your performance on a track, you go on the AMG track package. It will actually look for the nearest racetrack as well. Around here, we have no racetrack, but on a racetrack, you can basically time yourself. Other elements, well, AMG performance gives you the option to see what's happening in the vehicle. On the engine front, whenever you go on the right pedal, the amount of power coming in, amount of torque coming in, it has the consumption meter as well. Consumption, by the way, I came from Vesari to Gurgaon today in the morning, and the display 8.5 km/h with the AC running in a high manner because I had the top down. You also have the dynamic select, so basically you can go between your comfort, your sport plus and the individual. Likewise, with the AMG dynamics from the rotary knob, you can control a lot of things from the screen. You can know what's happening. You're in pro, basic, sport plus, sport, everything from a sports car experience point of view is bundled up in the E53 AMG. Now in the intro part, I spoke about space for four people. So yes, I'll be going into the rear bench of the E53 AMG. Going there is not really easy because it's a two-door setup. So what you do is you pull this lever on the side of both the seats, get the backrest up, and automatically it's powered. The seat starts going ahead, and this is a space I'll use to climb into the last bench. Is it good enough? Well, let's find out. Now, getting into the second row is actually not very tough. In fact, someone who's more leaner and fitter than me will not have an issue coming in. And once here, I'll get the seat back. Now, this seat is positioned for my height. So anyone who's 6 feet tall and an equally tall person at the back, this is not bad. So even right now, before getting the top down, my head is touching, but then it's okay. It's a convertible. So what? So let's get the top down. So the plus points first. With the top down, if you're going for your Goa road trip, like the good old movie Dil Chahta Hai, three of you or four of you, you can actually have the wind in the hair experience. And you also have a curtain coming in over here, and the safety rollover bar I told you is behind this curtain. In an emergency situation, it will come out in a fraction of a second. So safety wise, you are sorted. But this is actually only for two adults. The central tunnel is pretty wide because of the all-wheel drive setup. You do have a cup holders over here. You have your AC vents over here with individual temperature control for the rear passengers. Your rear power window switches are right over here. If I want, I can take this up or down, whatever. And I also have a place to keep my mobile phone. So practically wise, it's sorted. It's not an everyday four-seater car, but for the weekends or a long drive, definitely can be a four-seater vehicle. One small issue is the boot space or the lack of it. Like most Mercedes models, you have to press the three-pointed logo to access the boot, and this is where the issue comes into the picture. Because the hood basically goes into this part automatically, you also have a space saver wheel coming in over here. The actual usable boot space is tiny. The solution, you can actually take out the spare wheel, and then you have decent amount of space for 3 to 4 soft bags, which is actually what you want for a Goa trip, right? Now, this is the USP of the E53, the huge motor under the long bonnet. Now, in terms of figures on paper, it's a 3000cc turbo petrol engine with 6 cylinders. It's not V6, it's inline, basically 6 cylinders. And the magic here is the Eco Boost. Now, what is that? It's basically a combination of a starter motor and an alternator, an electric motor, and that electric motor gives boost to the engine. How much? Hear me out. This one puts out 435 horses and the boost is additional 22 bhp. But more importantly, this one gives you 520 Nm of torque and the boost 250. That's almost 50% more torque coming in because of the EQ boost. Now, all this massive colossal power and torque go to the all the four wheels. It's not front or rear wheel drive, it's a 4Matic, so it's an all-wheel drive through a very clever 9-speed gearbox. Why clever? Well, I'll explain you that in the later part of the video. Merck claims 0 to 100 in less than 5 seconds. Is that possible? Let's find out. This is one party trick that you are definitely gonna love in front of your friends and family members, or even in traffic conditions. Doing this in traffic will literally leave a smile on others' faces. Really cool. You can do this up to speeds of 50 kilometers per hour. I did this right now on the open expressway, no one around. So yeah, up till 50 kilometers per hour, you can play around with this party trick of the E53 AMG Cabriolet. Now, at the same time, this car has long legs. Why do I say so? Well, the 9-speed gearbox in the 9th gear at 1500 RPM, you are doing over 100 kilometers per hour. So yeah, even for your cross-country runs on a good smooth expressway, you can expect double-digit figures in terms of the actual mileage from this monster of a car.
apart from the usual drive modes, you also have the AMG dynamics, because this is the AMG version. You can toggle that from this rotary knob on the left side of the steering wheel. The right one is for the drive modes and the left one is for playing around with the AMG settings. In my case, I have been using both the comfort as well as the sport mode. Sport mode, of course, just sharpens up the response from the right pedal, the way the gear ratio is changing. So this is super enjoyable, especially around twisties. How much? Well, see for yourself. Don't get me wrong, in the comfort mode, it is still very, very enjoyable as a sports car experience. Also, what has surprised me is the ride quality that this car has to offer. It's the gorgeous alloy wheels with the low profile tires, and even then, over your undulations in a normal daily routine, the potholes and all, they are taken care in a very good manner for what is basically a supercar of sorts. Now, open roads aside, how does she fare inside city limits or in traffic jams like the one I'm stuck right now? Well, happy to report, in spite of the long wheelbase of the vehicle, it does not scare you or intimidate you very easily. Once you get used to the width and the length of the vehicle, it's actually like any other car you would drive in traffic conditions. The side mirrors are usable, they are large, even this inside mirror. All three of these come together to give you a good view of what's happening around on the road. Apart from that, the suspension, I told you earlier also, it will surprise you in a good manner. In spite of the ultra low profile tires, the sidewall is this thin. In spite of that, the ride quality is acceptable. It's of course not plush, but it's definitely acceptable. Also, when you are light on the right pedal, the transmission tends to upshift very early to save fuel. In fact, the first five gears, they come in very quickly. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, something you can see on the screen. So I told you in the initial part, it's got multiple personalities. You want to have your share of grinning moments on the open roads, fun with the car. It will do that inside city limits, gentle inputs on the right pedal. It will just keep on upshifting very early. Of course, being an AMG, it is loud and enjoyable for those who want their cars to sound nice. How nice? Well, for example, I'm in the sport mode right now. Downshift. I think that's good enough. That's pretty good.
And that brings us to the end of this video. In my opinion, the E53 AMG Cabriolet ends up ticking all the right boxes for a typical customer who's in the market for a sports car with a practical touch. In my books, it looks jaw-dropping gorgeous. It's got a great engine. It's got space for four people and ample practical touches. And then high levels of safety that Merc cars are known for globally and in the Indian market. At an asking price of 1.3 crore ex-showroom, I think with the AMG kit and the AMG add-ons, there's definitely something you could look as a buyer if you're in the market for a proper sports car that's practical as well.